Now I'm going to talk about the question, what does it mean when we have code that doesn't get covered? For example, if we're using statement coverage, what happens when we have some statements that we haven't been able to cover? And there are basically three possibilities. So the first possibility is that the uncovered code was simply infeasible. And infeasible code means exactly what it sounds like. It's code that can't be executed under any circumstances. So let's say that we're writing the checkrep function for a balanced tree data structure. So at some point in the checkrep, we're going to assert that the tree is balanced. Then in the implementation of the balance method, we're going to check if the left subtree and the right subtree have the same height, and if not, we're going to return false. If the tree becomes unbalanced, we're going to return false, causing an assertion violation. Assuming that our code is not buggy, assuming that is that we're testing a correct tree, we're never going to be able to return false from our balanced function. And of course, a coverage tool is going to tell us that we failed to achieve code coverage for this particular statement in the code. And then we have to ask ourselves, is that a bad thing? Is that bad that we failed to execute this line of code? And of course, it's not bad because that code only can execute if we've made a mistake somewhere. So the proper response to this kind of situation is we just need to tell our coverage tool that we believe this line to be infeasible, and then the tool won't count this line against us when we're measuring code coverage. And so let's look at an example of this. What I have here is an open source AVL tree. An AVL tree is somewhat analogous to the splay tree that we already looked at in the sense that it's a self-balancing binary search tree. As you can see, there's quite a lot of code here. AVL trees have a reputation for being fairly complicated as these things go. The code comes with its own test suite, so let's run it under the coverage monitor. Okay, now let's look at the output. We can see here that out of the 389 statements in the AVL tree, we failed to run 61 of them, and 20 branches were partially executed. So we can see that there are some various minor failures of the test suite to exercise interesting behaviors. So here is the AVL tree sanity check function. And what it does is checks a bunch of properties of the AVL tree, and if any of them fail, raises an exception. Every statement here that raises an exception has failed to have been covered, and then the branches which test the condition which leads to raising the exception are only partially covered. So superficially, we haven't gotten very good coverage of this function. But actually, of course, what we hope is that this AVL tree code is correct, and these are truly infeasible. And if we really believe that, what we can start doing is go ahead and start telling the coverage tool to ignore these. And the way we do that is to go back to the source code and mark some of these with a comment that has a special form, pragma, no cover. And if I go ahead and do this for the rest of these, then we should see that it does the right thing. All right, so now we'll run a coverage tool again and see if things look a little bit better. Okay, good. Well, so I didn't get all of this code, but we can see now that the coverage tool has marked these in sort of a light gray color, indicating that it's ignoring the fact that they weren't covered because we told it to.